art of strategic studying. What is strategic studying? Strategic studying means you don't study everything. That is foolish. You have to study the things, those things that have the greatest probability of appearing. Now, how do you study that? How do you study that? Exactly. Previous year's question papers are the best, best resource for you. You know why? Why is that? Why is that? Because people are not creative. People don't like putting effort year after year. So the easiest thing for people to do is to follow the same pattern. If you have to create different things year after year, it takes a lot of effort. Right? And the vast majority of our population is not, doesn't want to put in, they may be creative internally, but may not want to put in the work. It takes time. To create a radically different question takes time. So they will follow the same patterns. And all you need to know is the pattern. Because then the variation will be slightly here and there. But once you know the pattern, once you know the broadhead, you can study. So don't go and study everything. When you're studying for your boards, I'm giving you some tips for your boards also. Remember, strategic studying. Strategic studying. Identify the paper, see the pattern. Study the pattern. Become a master of the pattern. And then tell yourself, discuss between yourselves, what do you think will come this time? You guess about five questions that will come. He guesses about five. That's what we did. When I was at Oxford, all of us guessed the kind of questions that would come. And out of all the guesses, 60% came. 60%. Calculated guessing. Very simple. So as a result of which, we were able to enjoy most of the year and study only towards the end. But in the end, we studied strategically. Because even in a university like Oxford, which is supposed to be a leading university, people still are not creative. They still don't want to put in work. Okay? So they lift, and all, not only that, people are scared. They don't want to divert too much from the earlier pattern because they think it upsets students. So there are a lot of other issues. So with your 12th boards and with CLAT as well, you can be sure that the earlier pattern would be significantly followed. CLAT, of course, will have, I think the changes will be announced within a couple of days from now. But by and large, the pattern will be the same. Logical reasoning, legal reasoning, English, mathematics, GK. Right? And most of these sections are very, once you've already done logical reasoning questions. You know the patterns, various patterns. Once you know the patterns, you become familiar with it, then it's very easy for you to exactly how to structure your mind to work it out. All you have to do is sequence it in your mind. Sequence it. And remember that you are very lucky to be doing this exam because we trained blind children in Hyderabad. It was in Hyderabad training blind children. You know how difficult it is for them? Right? For you, if I give you a question here, legal principle. Legal principle. They did these questions? Nothing is an offense which is done in the exercise of right of private defense. Huh? How did you find these questions? NLU Delhi, 2008. Good paper? You liked it, you solved it. Now when you read this legal principle, nothing is an offense which is done in the exercise of the right of private defense. The right also extends to lawfully causing the death of the assailant if the offense which occasions the exercise of the right of private defense be... Very complicated language, right? So you have to break it down, underline. When you have to start by underlining. Nothing is an offense. Right? So they start by a negative. They're not saying something is an offense. They're saying this is not an offense. When they say nothing is an offense, it means it's not an offense. If it is done in the exercise of the right of private defense, so you got your first proposition. It is not an offense if it is done in the exercise of the right of private defense. Proposition clear? Mark it out. First proposition. Second, this right also extends to lawfully causing the death of the assailant. If the offense which occasions the exercise of the right of private defense be. Okay? So they're telling you that normally you have a right to private defense. Right? And sometimes this right to private defense can also extend to causing the death. Private defense means, what does defense mean? When do you defend? When do you defend? When do you defend? When attack. You play football, right? Who's the defender? Trying to stop. Correct. Right? Defender is trying to stop. attacker is trying to move. So when you're defending, someone's attacking. So they're saying that sometimes you have the right to defend. And sometimes a defend can also mean mardo. Put a knife in. But not every time, because normally putting a knife in means you're attacking. This is an exceptional situation where you're defending by putting a knife in. And when is that circumstance? It goes on to explain. An assault which reasonably causes the apprehension of death or grievous hurt. Which means if somebody comes to you with a gun, is going to shoot you. You think is going to shoot you. Then you take a knife. Because you want to save your life. You want to save your life. So in this case, the defense is justified, although you're killing someone, because you think you're going to die. Right? You think you're going to die. So proposition is clear. So mark out, when you read a legal reasoning question, remember, mark out each proposition. Because that's what it turns on. All this turns on words. So you got one proposition which says nothing is an offense which is done in the exercise of private defense. Which means the first proposition is if you do something for private defense, you're exempted. Because the law thinks that you're justified. You had a valid cause. You weren't out there to harm the other person. You were out there only to defend yourself. You have a right to defend yourself. Right? Because the law can't come and protect you all the time. When someone's going to harm you, a police won't be there waiting to arrest that person. Sometimes you have to protect yourself. That's why you need to learn karate, kung fu, judo. Any of you learn karate, kung fu, judo? No. Do you keep a knife? You don't keep anything for self-defense? Do you keep a gun? A stick? A stone? What do you keep for self-defense? Huh? Fist! Saurav, very good. Saurav, fist is enough. Solid punch, a solid knockout. Huh? An assault. Okay, so it says, this right, second proposition, that this right, when they say this right of what? No. Wrong. First proposition, nothing is an offense which is done in the exercise of the right of private defense. Second sentence says,